going digging.
Finally upgrading my coil cover on my X-Scout. The old one was beat up. Literally tore it to shreds. It's been busted. Had to get it off there, get a brand new one. We did. Get the brand new coil cover. Get out of there, bug. Got the brand new coil cover. Looks awesome. Fits like a glove.
Get out of my yard, you dark treasure hunters.
Maybe we should go dumpster diving in his yard. Let's see what he brought us.
Just walking up to his house, look what we eyeballed in his driveway. Houston, we have an earring. It's like I was meant to find treasure or something. We got a little bit of sleep last night. We're gonna hit it all day at the park, at the festival, get some awesome footage, find some treasure. Let's take you guys along. Treasure time! I haven't been in the park more than 5 minutes and I've already seen three other guys metal detecting. The competition is fierce out here. And then I gotta deal with these guys. I planned on staying here the whole day. I'm ready for the long haul. There's gonna be probably 350,000 people to come out to this festival over the course of the next couple days. Right now the plan, hello. Right now the plan is work the dry sand. It's only about 60 degrees this morning. Had a really cold night, which is awesome, but it'll get up into the 80s today. People will be in the water. They were in the water yesterday because it was the same way. Oh yeah, penny time. Just pulled an older nickel, 1953. I'll make a separate tutorial on how to do grid searching on the beach, but I just found a nickel at the epicenter of that spiral. Got a mid-tone. I also have another high tone, but the mid-tone that was right here, look what's in the scoop, guys. Check it out. That would be a ring. Definitely has a copper look to it. But man, we are swinging for the ring. All right, let's dig up this high tone real quick. Put the ring on the carabiner. And just like that, we got a quarter. So a ring, a quarter, not bad. One of the questions I get about beach hunting, people see these sand machines, the groomers going up and down the beach, and they think they're picking up all of the coins, rings, but let's face it, they don't. Those items are too small. There's no way that they're gonna pick those up. Case in point, look where he just drove over. He's done one pass down the beach so far. And you can see all of the debris that's still being left behind. Cigarette butts, a sock. There's just plenty of things that that sweeper cannot pick up. What the tongs on those sweepers are picking up are things like this. The grass that's washing up, large sticks, plus those tongs, they're going less than I would say 2 inches deep, if that. So don't worry if you have a beach cleaner on your beach. It's not gonna find your stuff. That's what this thing's for, right here. This is your number one beach cleaner. Get one of these, I guarantee you, you will be finding some treasure. All right, we just found a new scoop. Who brings this to the beach, really?
Excuse me. You know, I'm thinking about getting one of these as well.
Yeah.
What kind do you recommend?
Do you wanna just do the beach? Do you wanna go in the water?
No, my son is, he bought a Civil War era farmhouse.
Ah.
There's just a lot of history there, so something that would just penetrate the ground.
Yeah.
You know, a couple inches.
How much you want to spend?
You know, if it does the job it needs to do.
Yeah.
I mean, what would be reasonable? $500.
$500 would get a good one. I would recommend, because this one's waterproof. Get the AT Pro. It's by Garrett.
Garrett
AT Pro. Yeah, this is a Mine Lab Excalibur. This one will run you between $1,000 to $1,200.
That's an investment.
Yeah, you can get an AT Pro for a good deal
By
Garrett for $450, $500.
That'd be a good price range.
Yeah.
And it would do the job.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yep, and it's waterproof up to 10 feet. like the unit is, the headphones that they come with, that one wouldn't dive with it. But if you wanted to, like, just, like, if you ever did come to the beach or something, you could go on the water with it just fine.
That's really awesome. Well, thanks a lot.
Yeah, no problem.
Good luck finding something.
Well, you know, we just got this, so. Just to show you guys that the beach groomer does not get everything, I've been walking the line of the first track that that groomer went, and look what we have right here. Penny! Penny, penny! 1 cent! Don't feel bad if you got a groomer on your beach, because then you can take your dog there. Yeah, dad joke. All right, guys, check out this beauty. Very nice, very nice. The chain is marked sterling, and it's 925 on the back of the pendant. For sale. Alright, $6.99. How often do you find a brand new McLaren? Okay, maybe slightly used. It was part of a wedding band set. Let's see if we can find the other half. So I just dug that 14 karat ring in almost the same spot. Picked up this earring, just copper. So I have no idea what this was. It might have been a ring. It's marked sterling. Doesn't look sterling, but it is tore up, sharp. All right, found a half penny. Like literally half a penny.
The morning hunt was awesome. We found 3 rings. Let's see, got a couple little stud earrings, bunch of change, a little bit of trash still, but it's out there. The water is freezing. It flipped on us. Last week it was probably 74, 75 degrees. It was warm for Lake Michigan. Right now, it's pushing maybe 60, probably in the 50s though. Made a little picnic lunch. Now we're just relaxing in the hammock. Took a nap, got woke up by the police. They thought I was drunk. I told them I was sleeping. And then I walked off and I attached it over here. So here's my setup. We've got the tree there. We've got me. It's hooked to my car. Everybody's been jonesing, just jonesing about my setup. Kids are coming by. Grandmas and grandpas are coming by. They're like, that is awesome. I know. And here's the view. Not bad. We'll be right back.
that festival's been going on for the entire week. It's Friday. It's been a week since the last rings that I've found, but it's the first time I've been out, and it's a lot different today. Hey, we got a nice little low rainbow. All right, maybe there is some gold out there. I love it. So here's the scoop. I've been hunting for about 2 hours now, and I committed a cardinal sin for YouTubers. I didn't bring my camera. So all of the things that I've dug, you're not gonna see. The reason that I didn't take it is because the mount that I was going to use for the GoPro is on my Excalibur, and as soon as I turned the Excalibur on, it was dead. Luckily, we've got the AT Pro back here. I always carry a backup. And it's a good thing I did, because check it out. This was from the first 2 hours out there, and so far it's looking really good. First ring I found was actually this guy right here, this little copper one with a blue stone. And then the very next thing that we found was this coin from the Bahamas. That rang up like a nickel. And then immediately next to that, we found this ring. And this gave me a heart attack right here. Oh, I saw the stones. It sounded like a nickel too. And then I picked it up. It's super light. I'm pretty sure it's titanium. It's missing some stones, but that's all right, because so far we've dug 3 rings today. I think this little guy, the little heart one, is silver. And then I eyeballed this Monet little clip-on earring. We gotta get back out there. There's one other person detecting right now, and the Fury of Lake Michigan is still happening.
Here's the take from this weekend. Awesome hunt. 7 rings. Loved it. I've got this high school class ring. Looks like it's just plated. I don't even think it's sterling silver. I think it was just one of those salesman rings that they would go around to the high schools, kind of showcase and then offer students the ability to get it in sterling or 10 karat gold or whatever have you. We also picked up this little guy. You saw that in the dry sand. Don't see any markings on it, just a single little stone, probably a kid's ring. This beat up piece of who knows what, it's jagged. I don't know if it was a ring or what it was. It's marked sterling on the inside. Still got to test it, but that could be a small little sterling toe ring or something along that effect. This was the last ring we found of the day. At first, again, I saw a little glint of gold. I was hoping for the big ticket, but again, just a kid's ring, junk, nothing too fantastic other than the fact that it's a ring. Same thing with this one, looks like it's just plated, kid's ring. Then we got these nice tickets here, butter, simply butter, I love it. This ring, I searched all over the place to see if it had any friends, and we just couldn't locate anything. It's 14 karat. That's a nice piece of butter right there. Delicious. And then again, we have this 10 karat little engagement ring. 9 stones in it. Still got to test them, but they look good. A couple little diamond chips. And lastly, we've got this beauty, this pendant. It's marked 925 on the back. And the chain is also marked 925 Italy. So that is a keeper. Found that in the dry sand, and unfortunately, I don't think I'm going to be able to resell this one. It's not going to the scrap, because guess what? The fiance already picked it out. It's hers. She likes it. So, happy customer there. We got some gold, some rings. So now you can see all of the other things that I was digging all weekend. Targets everywhere. There's just so much. It's unbelievable how much trash we dug up, how many coins we actually were picking up finally. Again, the water was cold. There weren't a lot of people in it over the weekend, but for those that did go in and for the sand that was getting tossed around from the waves and the currents, it moved some things around where we were definitely able to score plenty of different goodies here, and we had a great weekend. So again, thanks for coming along, guys. I hope you enjoyed the ride, enjoyed the video, and I can't wait to see what you find. Leave a comment below, subscribe to the channel, and as always, keep swinging for the ring.